few questions here of John.
How's this supposed to be been for you?
You know, it's been great. Really busy, just trying to get up to speed on our defense and you know, the personnel and whatnot. Just get ready to go.
John, just talk about what it means to come back to Nebraska after playing here.
Yeah, you know what? It's it's obviously a great thing. Love it here. Always loved it here. And it's a great chance to be part of this great staff and this great program, historic program.
How did that go, the conversation with Coach Riley?
You know, it was just when I initially interviewed. Is that what you're asking?
Well, he said you won the interview. Uh-huh. That's why he hired me.
Yeah, no, thanks. Yeah, I mean, it was obviously, you know, it was a typical interview, which you would get in college football, you know, about scheme, you know, recruiting, you name it. Yeah, those things that went on and felt it went extremely well. And obviously, you know, it went well, obviously, right? But excited to be here, excited to be part of this program.
And John, when you mm-hmm. Got out of your playing career and wanted to go and coach, was it ever in the back of your mind?
I think any former player that had success at his college would want to go back and coach here. I don't. It's a no-brainer, I think, for any former player. I mean, especially with the experience that you get here at Nebraska. I mean, they develop you on and off the field, and a chance to come back and work with young men and help develop them, and both on and off the field, was a no-brainer for me.
You're kind of a throwback to a different era in Nebraska football. Mm-hmm. Is that something that you're going to try to somehow convey to players?
Are you calling me old right now? Is that what you're saying? You know what? You can't help it. I mean, this is a great program, and Coach Riley's done a tremendous job with it, and as well as his staff. Anything that I can do in any part, I can roll, especially with a role I can fill, especially with our defensive line, to get them to understand the toughness of this program and what it takes to play in this conference. Obviously, I'm going to do that. So, yeah.
Yep. What's your biggest challenge right now when you look at the guys as far as getting them to where they need to be?
Know what they look like in the helmet, you know, and who they are. You know, these are great guys, and you know, the challenge is always just getting fundamentally sound here this spring, and the fall will take care of itself once we get through the spring.
John, you played in Nebraska in '92 when it was kind of the stepping stone mm-hmm. to those national championships. Can mm-hmm. you kind of relate that area to what it is now to get back to that championship level?
Yeah, I mean, it's, you know, it's a long story. I think it first starts with just, you know, being dominant up front, offensive line, defensive line, and just continue to getting great players in the weight room. I mean, it's a lot more than just conveying a short message, and I think that our staff here is doing an excellent job letting the guys on the team know exactly what we've got to do to continue to get where we're, you know, the end result we're all after. So.
How do you go about trying to install a culture of toughness on the defensive line?
Yeah, you know, that's a day in and day out thing. I think this is a pretty tough group. I think they're extremely talented. We just got to get them fundamentally sound and get dialed in, get to know me. I've got to get to know them. So it's you know, like a lot of questions they're more than just one short answer. I mean, it's going to be a day in and day out process with them, and I'm excited to work with them. Had a chance to meet with all of them and looking forward to Saturday.
How closely did you keep tabs on Nebraska when you were coached in Northern Michigan, the junior college? And I mean, were you following this stuff here the last 10, 15 years pretty closely?
Yeah, I mean, look, if you know, wherever you play or wherever you coach, you always know what the place is doing. And obviously very proud of this program and the improvement it's had over the years and looking for even greater here down the road.
Coach, you've got time for about one more.
You played under Coach Riley when you were with the Chargers. Mm-hmm. Talk about that experience and, you know, that relationship you have with him.
Yeah, I think anyone who's ever met him would say, you know, the same thing. What a great guy. And obviously I thought a ton of him. So I called him about this job. You know, I thought it was a win-win for me, a place I love and a staff that I admire. And Coach Banker and now Billy Devaney and the rest of the coaches on the staff have had a great relationship with for a long time.
Coach Osborne.